What's up? SlyGumbi here, and welcome to another Titanfall 2 video. In this video, I'm just going to recap some of my thoughts and experiences of the grind so far. Now, I've been playing the crap out of this game since release. I mean, the crap out of this game. I did take an evening off to play some Battlefield 1, but essentially this has been my main squeeze since release date. Since the 24-hour stream. Let's see. So I'm Gen 4. I hit Gen 4 last night. Gen 4, technically level 5 into Gen 4. Let's see how long it's taken me to get here. Two days and 23 hours. So basically 3 days. So it looks like I'm averaging about 24 hours, about a day to regen. I know some people are getting there quicker. I just wanted to note that I'm not saying that I am the fastest. I was probably one of the first, if not the first, to hit Gen 2 because we grinded like hell for the first 24 hours. But just playing the crap out of it, about 20 hours, 24 hours, 23 hours is a good average probably for most people. The people that are really, really pushing for power leveling, I'm sure you can get there quicker. I mean, somebody told me they can do it in 17 hours. That's insane. You could probably do 17 hours your first time through leveling all your guns to level 5 and all your titans to level 5. But after level 5, all of your guns are no different than when they're level 15 to level. So it's the fastest way to get merits 1 through 5 on everything. We didn't realize that until about 12 hours, 16 hours into our 24-hour stream. And clearly I'm not doing that now. Well, I've got my assault rifle I'm using is Gen 10. I'm starting to use some other guns. So some of the things I wanted to go over really quick. Pilot abilities. Actually, what do we got here? Let's see, my career kills 33,298. I've had 203 wins. I can't show you my deaths. I can't show you my win percentage. Can't show you my KD. Can't show anything. It's a little irritating. They don't have any form of stat tracking. They also don't have any form of leaderboard, so I couldn't tell you when I hit Gen 2 if I was the first. I can't tell you how many other Gen 4s are out there above me. I know there's a lot of streamers out there that play the game. I haven't seen any Gen 4s. I only saw maybe one or two Gen 3s while I was Gen 3. So I'd like to know how far ahead of the pack I am. I know there are a couple guys I've heard in stream that there was a dude that is Gen 12 already. And I believe that guy was utilizing the happy hours. He would change network to boost it. And it sounds like I was also told the other night that Respawn Entertainment put out a patch to prevent that form of exploit or whatever. You can't abuse the happy hour anymore. I don't know if that's true or not. That's just what I've been told. There was also somebody that was, I guess, Gen 9. And what was he doing? I can't remember. So there are people ahead of me. I'm not saying I'm the fastest by any means. I just play a crap ton of the game. On that note, when it comes to power leveling, just play the game. Play the game. You can really make use of leveling everything to level 5 for your first time through. But after that, just pick something you like. Go with it. Run with it. Have fun. It'll come. It will come. Things I've noticed and what I enjoy and let's see. Pilot abilities. So again, hands down, the holo pilot is by far, in my opinion, the most powerful. I troll with it. I love it. If you've seen any of my streams, I'm a beast with it. Another one that's really popular that is effective is the pulse blade. I've seen some pretty crazy people use Stim. For those of you like me who ADS and have a habit of ADSing like crazy, if somebody is stimming all around you, jumping like a crack addict, and you're trying to ADS on them, they are going to poop all over you. So the stim pack is something that I think is... I don't see a lot of people using it, but people that do use it that are good at it, they are definitely... It's like an annoying gnat that you cannot swat, and they will teabag, they will kill, they punch, they kick, they fly, they're everywhere. It's annoying. So that's an ability I've been slowly starting to practice and use, especially with shotguns. It's kind of a fun ability. Another one that I've been really wanting to practice and try to figure out, we spent a good couple hours last night in stream on the phase shift. What we're noticing with the phase shift is you're not going invisible. You're basically yanking yourself into a different dimension for like 2 seconds, 1/1000, 2/1000, and you're back. I am very aggressive in how I play. And so my thought was I wanted to run up to somebody, start shooting, or run up to somebody, get into a room, see some players, pop phase shift, run behind them, come out, assassinate. I thought you could do a lot of cool trolling abilities with this. But what happens is you pop it, a big flash of smoke appears on the screen. All of them see the smoke. You disappear. Where they were standing, you can then run to where you think they were. When you go into this other world, everything disappears. Players disappear, items disappear, so you don't see what's happening. What happens to me most of the time, we even tried it again last night for a few hours because I was making a point on stream. It actually kills me more because I'll run into a room, I'll see somebody, they see me, I pop phase shift, I run to the back of the room trying to get an advantage point. Well, they, at the same time, see this dude running at them, disappears. They usually backpedal. They either run forward, they're readjusting. So when I come out of the phase, I am even more disoriented than I was going in, and everybody's in panic, and it's I can't for the life of me make that an offensive ability. Now, we did learn that it's purely defensive, really. I mean, it's just a defensive ability. You get into a shit sandwich and you need to evac, you pop the phase shift, boom, you can clearly run away. And because you're in a different phase, you take zero damage. Nobody can see you. You are in a different world. If you are on a detonating nuclear titan and you pop phase shift and it blows up, you could be on the dude's ankle, on top of it, sitting on the ground in proximity of it. Regardless, you will take zero damage. You are in a different dimension. With that said, I thought it was really cool with how we got to the idea last night of practicing with it. Is I wanted to, I'm trying to figure out how to troll people with it. I troll with the hologram, and I was thinking phase shift could be cool. So I was thinking, let's use satchels. And the idea was I could run up to people, drop a satchel, phase shift, boom, and destroy everybody. Respawn was a little smart on that idea. So what happens is you toss your satchel down, you phase shift, and while you phase shift, it readies up your gun. So then you have to switch back to your detonator. If you haven't thrown a second satchel charge, it's going to throw a it doesn't work. And what ended up happening more times than less, by the time I was able to detonate it, I'd be coming back into reality and I would detonate myself, and they were already be gone. So the idea of running in, sabotaging them, jumping out into a different phase to avoid the explosion doesn't work. But still working on it. Still working on trying to figure out how to make phase shift an offensive ability. Something else we noticed that was kind of cool, and really one of the only things I could see myself using phase shift until I can figure out how to troll people with it. If you're on a Titan and you jump off, you don't have the choice. It just automatically removes the core and jumps you off, which is a kind of a big pet peeve. Of mine. I missed the rodeo aspect of the first Titanfall. I'm going into too much detail here on this. But anyways, phase shift, you jump on a Titan, you pull the core out, you are then pooped out on the ground and next to the Titan, and now you have to run while they either try to boost, to kill you, punch you, shoot you, whatever. It's really, it's hard to get away from Titans when you take the core out, unless you're already on a wall, in a corridor or something tight. If you phase shift, you take the core with you out of reality, they can't see you, they can't see the marker, you are gone. You get two phase shifts, so basically you have 4 seconds to, once you land off of the Titan, you can phase shift and get away safely. We also tried using phase shift while on top of the Titan so that his friends couldn't kill you, couldn't do anything, and you'd be able to take the core out safely. The game is designed to where you are not able to phase shift. You are basically locked into an animation the moment you land on the Titan, which is kind of lame. But so the phase shift while on the Titan does not work as well. The AWOL is another ability that I am kind of a fan of, but kind of not at the same time. The run-and-gun aspect of using AWOL doesn't work. The activation period of throwing the AWOL down takes too long. So if you run around a corner and there's a player coming at you, you're both running, you take the time to throw your AWOL down. They've already gunned up or hip-fired, you're dead before your shield wall activates. Your shield wall will most likely pop up after your body is on the ground. Now for the quote-unquote scumbags of the game that want to sit around the edge of the map or on rooftops with sniper rifles or Hemlocks or G2s or even any gun, really, the AWOL is pretty dominant. In objective-based games, it's a killer ability. For those of you who aren't reading or figuring out what it does, the AWOL is basically an orange shield that you see planted on the ground. It's a little concaved shield that you stand behind. While they are shooting out of this wall, they basically have amped weapon damage. I don't know if you guys know that. So if you see that shield, don't think you're necessarily safe. Some of the things you can do, you can phase shift through to get to the other side. You can shoot holograms at them to disorient them. Gravity stars will suck them through the shield, so then you can kill them. The AWOL, unlike there's a boost that gives you another wall, but it's a blue shield. The AWOL doesn't take damage and pop. It literally is just on a timer. It lasts indefinitely until that timer is gone. So you can't nuke it with Titans to get through to kill the pilot. As long as that shield is up, it is a unstoppable force. You can't destroy it. You have to wait for it to disappear. So unlike the boost where you throw the blue shield down, we've used it where four of us have gotten behind it to try to take out Titans. And when the Titans look at us and shoot, that shield is gone and we are all naked and usually dead. So the blue shield from the boost is not as good as the orange shield from the tactical ability. Grappling hook, I still am not a fan of the grappling hook. It's really, in my opinion, just a style kill, style ability. It really doesn't even help you traverse the map that fast. I've got a bunch of guys that use grappling hook, and we've speed run to objectives, and we can still get there at the same time. I've gotten in arguments with people in streams. Some of the guys I play with that are decent, we get along. They swear by it, and they think it's a game changer. I do not. But to each its own, I'm not a fan of it. Cloak still, I think the most used ability in the game and the most useless. Like, I would pick grappling hook over cloak. Cloak, you stand out like a sore thumb. Unless you are at the edge of the map or in a bush sniping with the cloak. Not a fan. Like, anytime I see it, I poop on them. And I call it out. If you watch my streams, I laugh and teabag everybody that has cloak. You're not invisible. You're just a blur. I don't know why people use it. I know that they have some kind of immunity or something to, like, map hacks and sonar. You're still there, but you're not. I haven't really tested it. I don't use it. I'll sit down and make a video on it just to see all of the benefits of it, really, if there is anything besides being a camo-less blur, colorless blur. But yeah, so cloak, I still see the majority of players use cloak. And then grappling hook. Pulse blade seems to be disappearing. I'm not seeing as many pulse blades as I did the first time through the game. That has been replaced with the map hack boost. I see a tremendous amount of map hacks, which is basically pulse blade, but the entire map reveals you and all your friends to the enemy team while it's alive. I don't know if there's really a counter to it. I do know that my holopilot prevents me from constantly dying due to map hacks, because people always shoot the hologram. It's kind of like a go fetch. They always go for the hologram. Always. I don't understand. Maybe it's the way I play it. It has to be the way I play it. Anyway, so yeah, those are what I've experienced so far with the pilot abilities. Guns. I'm seeing YouTube videos talking about cars and the SMGs, the Volt. I know a lot of people use the Volt in the car. I'm using those right now. I've clearly gotten the R201 to Gen 10, level 4. In my opinion, the R201 is the best all around, hands down, gun in the game. I drop all the SMG users in close range. And I have some SMG user friends that claim that they can outgun or out hip fire the R201. Some guys say they can't. I kind of feel the same way. I've been using the car. And 50-50 of the time, if I gun up against an R201, it's 50-50. I think that either it needs to have a little bit of a lower fire rate, the R201 does, to balance it. I think it's a little overpowered. That being said, it's my gun of choice. I don't want it to get changed or nerfed in any way. But sometimes I feel like an SMG up close should always win, and it doesn't. That's not the case. I know some people that love the car think the car is better. I'm currently using the car right now. I think I've got a Gen 3. Just with the accuracy, the power, the range, the fire rate with the 201, and then the consistent equalness of close range between the car and the R201, the R201 outperforms at range, at close range. It's just a better gun all around. It's more stable. It doesn't have as much recoil than the car. Volt. I got the Volt to Gen 2. I like it, but I don't. It's not as powerful as the car and the 201. It's more accurate. But I tend to, like, if I square up with somebody, I come around a corner, we both shoot at the same time, I tend to lose more gunfights with the Volt SMG. So I'm not, it's not a gun that I like. But yeah, so those are the guns. I kind of stopped using the 201, so if you pop into the stream, I'll be using the SMGs. I'm bouncing between the Volt and the car. I'm going to get them to probably Gen 10 just so I have a valid background. If people want to argue, I'll be like, no, dude, guys, I've got close to 2,000 kills with both of these. And so that'll probably happen this week. I'll have that to Gen 10 probably the next day, the car. That's another thing that I'm seeing. The alternator is also, I don't see it as very much. It's a beast. If you get in within like 50 yards of somebody, you're done. You are absolutely destroyed. That thing, I love the alternator. I'm going to start using that a lot more. It's still level 5 for my first go through, but I'll start using that as well. I don't see myself using the R97. It's too inaccurate for my taste. The fire rate is nuts, but it's a little too inaccurate for my flavor. Shotguns, I enjoy shotguns. They're very hit or miss. I'm working on the Mastiff right now. But when I get pissed off, I always go back to the car, which I've got Gen 2 13 right now. The Volt, I've got Gen 2 2. Light machine guns are also really good in this game. And I'm seeing quite a bit of it. The Devotion. For those of you that haven't really played with it or not tried it, try this bad boy out. It basically shoots slow to begin with, but it amps up rather quickly, and it does a tremendous amount of damage, and the stability and the range on this thing is intense. If anybody tries to outgun you at range, and they stay out in the open, by the time your third, fourth bullet connects, they're dead. They can take the first couple hits, and if you're a little inaccurate, it might take a little bit more, but the moment your bullets start connecting, they are so close together, and they hit so hard. It's nuts. Basically, like, if I see blue bullets coming at me and they hit slow, I get behind cover, I pop back out, I work the guy down. But if I try to one-up the dude, even with my assault rifle, typically they will win every time with this bad boy. When I first used it, I didn't like it because it hit slow. But as it amps up, dude, you can beat snipers with this thing. It is ridiculous. So don't underestimate the LMGs. The Spitfire also in this one versus the first game is super accurate, but it hits like a truck. I really enjoy using the Spitfire. The L-Star, if you're running gunny and you want to hit fire, it is a beast as well. I mean, the light machine guns in this game are super viable. I clearly haven't done a lot with it. They're all level 5 for my first go-through. But I will be playing with these very soon. I don't know which one I like better. They're all very different on how they play. But I'll be using those again. I still have yet to use snipers. During the tech tests, I used the double take, which I enjoyed in Titanfall 1. I loved the Kraybar. Grenade launchers, still haven't used these at all. No real interest yet. But for the trends, it's typically Volt, Car, and 201. Still, the majority of the players I see use the 201. Some of the better players I'm seeing use the Devotion or the Devastator light machine gun. I'm seeing some Spitfires here and there. I saw my first smart pistol boost the other day. The dude didn't get me. I just saw pilot lock on, turned around, and dropped him. But it was the first time I saw it. I was kind of impressed that I'm seeing people starting to try different things. Moving on to Titans. since my 24-hour stream and hitting regen 1 where I was talking clearly about how I felt like everything's balanced. I still kind of feel that way. For those of you playing the game and want to complain and bitch, Legion. Let's talk about Legion. Scumbag Legion. Legion is, I think, if there's going to be a nerf, he'll probably get a nerf, or he needs a little bit of a nerf. And for those Legion players out there that want to get mad, that's fine. Go ahead and get mad. Legion's easy mode. It's totally easy mode. You get this auto. He's like, who was I watching? I was watching Darkness429 on Twitch. He's a big streamer. He loves Titanfall, loves EA games. But he was talking about Legion, and Legion is literally a mix between Scumbag Bastion from Overwatch and Soldier 74. Whatever the Soldier dude is from Overwatch. The dude is fucking... He's got so much damage. He's impossible to take down. And he's got the core ability, nukes anything on his screen. He doesn't have to aim at you. You could be an innocent bystander running by, not even knowing Legion's around the corner, holding right trigger, and you instantly die. And the dude has no skill. In regards to him being overpowered and needing a nerf, he doesn't necessarily... Playing now for 4 days, he's not undefeatable. If you get caught with your pants down out in the open field and he's around the corner or also in an open field, you're kind of screwed. But for the most part, if you see a Legion and you change how you play, they're sluggish, they're slow, their abilities aren't, they don't last forever. He's really, now that I'm aware of him, I don't even care. I just kind of laugh at people. It's kind of like Cloak. I play different. I adjust differently. If you and your buds or anybody you're playing with try some tactics to get around, you flank him, you work on him, you poke around corners. He's just this slow, sluggish fat guy that has this auto aim and a right trigger. He's not really a deciding factor. Now, guys that play multiple Legions or work as a group when Legions are on the field, they suck. They're suck. They're all scumbags. But Legion as a whole, nah. Ronin, for instance, Ronin will poop all over Legion. So it's kind of like everybody kind of has their counter. I've seen quite a bit of Tones do work to Legion as well. I play Northstar. I've been playing Northstar nonstop. He's Gen 5, level 5. And I poop on Legions. Unless I get caught in a corridor and don't have a way to get out of there and he pops his ult. Or even if he just right triggers, man. The dude is powerful. But... he's not overpowered. He's not going to win every situation. He definitely has his weak points, but he is definitely... He could use a nerf, in my opinion. He could, but he's not a game changer. If you play Legion, you are not guaranteed to be the most powerful person on the field. You will die, especially if you play against people that know how to take you down. Ronin, I stick my buddies. I've got some buddies that play Ronin, and they are literally looking for Legion. I have some buddies that play Legion, and they absolutely hate Tone. They say Tone poops on them. Scorch. I'm starting to see a lot more Scorches now. And if a Scorch gets up behind you and you don't see him coming, they can game over you pretty quickly. They are also very handy at controlling movement flow on the field. If you get somebody that plays Scorch more of a lane pusher or a control... person, they can shut down motion on certain sides of the field if you're playing objective. Scorch is somebody I want to start playing. I played him a lot during the tech test. I will probably move into Scorch. I really want to play Tone. Everybody plays Tone. Tone is awesome. So I'm either going to move to Ion or Scorch next. I did see somebody in Ion the other day. I think Ion might take a little bit more skill to play... successfully, I mean in a sense, successfully as in be a dominant force on the field. I did see one person the other day. I absolutely could not kill the guy. Man, he would play safe. He would come out and poke. He would use your shit against you. He was cool. He was very good. He didn't have a lot of kills. He didn't kill me. I kind of play safe. I played Northstar, so I have to play safe. But the dude was one of the top players on his team. And usually Ion is kind of just this average filler. It could have to do with the mentality of people not knowing how to play him. They say he's got a one difficulty. I don't know, man. He to play him successfully and dominate, I think it takes a lot more skill. He doesn't have really anything hard to use, but to not use up your energy and to maintain energy, he can be a force. I did see somebody that was super good with him. Ronin, again, level 1 difficulty, Radiant by the game. I think to be well and successful with him, it takes a high level of skill in and situationally getting in, getting out. I've seen some people throw that extra boost on him, and dude, he's kind of scary. I'll be a pilot on the ground, and then a Ronin will just come in, boost, 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 phase transfer, phase dash. I mean, the guy he's scary. Guys that are super aggressive with him, that get in and get out and get the job done, they're scary. Ronins can be scary, but for the most part, most players, the average player, the casual, that pick Ronin, they're just just throw a couple. You could almost down a Ronin in one clip of any anti-Titan weapon, dude. They're super squishy. They do a lot of damage when they get in close if you're not careful. But the average player that plays Ronin, they're just it's a waste of a Titan. I'm not gonna go into Tone. Everybody plays Tone. Everybody should be familiar with Tone. Tone is awesome. He's powerful, awesome. He's got the particle wall, which can be a group ability, his personal ability. The lock-ons are... I wish my North Star had a lock-on system similar to him. His salvo locks on, and he can shoot around corners. He can shoot above buildings, and it comes down. North Star's ability, salvo, when you're flying in the air, just seems kind of like this random vomit where some of them hit, some of them don't. So I kind of wish that I had the lock-on ability that Tone does. But, yeah, Tone is Tone and Legion, I think, are the most two favored Titans that I see. I see a lot of Ronins also because he's got a sword and he's cool. But unless you know what you're doing, he gets lit up and destroyed very quickly. Let's see. Banners and patches. So for the people that want to collect stuff, basically there's a patch for every weapon and item in the game that you regen once. So if you get every gun to level 20 or 21, I think it's 20. Let's see here. Legion. Okay, so all your Titans level 10 also get a patch. And then, Craybar level 20, R97 level 20, all your weapons that you get to level 20 will unlock a patch. There's a handful of challenges, like goosing somebody 3 times, which is killing a pilot that's been ejected, and gets you the Batman patch. I've already gotten that. I don't think I have any more challenge patches to unlock, just weapon and Titan and regen. Something I'm a little irritated that I'm not quite sure quite yet. That made no sense. I'm irritated. Some of the patches, let's see where they go. Gen 7, Gen 9, Gen 10. So according to the patches, there's only 10 gens. Then you go into the rest of them are all Advocate gift patches. If you head over to the banners. Loading. We go to page 7. And then, yeah. All the way down to the right-hand side. Unlocks at Gen 15. So you do have a Gen 15. I thought it went to Gen 10. So there's 15 gens. I was also told there was that guy that boosted to Gen 12. He's probably Gen 13 by now, or 14. But Gen 15 looks like the max gen. There's no patches now, so I'm going to be a Gen 10, but really a Gen 15. And nobody's not going to know, because there's no way to show your level or stat or leaderboards. So I'm a little irritated at that. But at my rate, I'll be Gen 15 in probably a week and a half. I'm averaging a gen every 24 hours. For those of you guys that have any kind of exploits or way to boost, or has anybody knows how to get a double XP, that'd be neat. I don't know how to get double XPs yet. I have not seen them. I don't know anybody that's gotten them. But that would definitely help out tremendously if they are available. They might not be available yet. I don't know. Something else I've noticed for some of you guys that are curious. Banners have 4 versions of every banner. There'll be a gold version, which gives you this prism spectrum that goes across it, and the gold nameplate where your gamer tag is at. Now, They also have, let's see, I didn't plan this to show this. Fire is another variant of it, where it's just fire. You have a black border next to your name. And then they've got Prism. If I can find one quickly. Nope. There's Prism right here, where you don't have the, it's basically gold, but without the gold nameplate. So your gamer tab has a black background, and then you have your rainbow Prism spectra that goes across it. So banners are kind of cool. Let's see. I am rocking. Which one am I rocking? This guy right here is for Gen 3. And Gen 4. That guy's Gen... No. I don't know where my Gen 4 is. Gen 4. The one I have got right there in the upper corner is Gen 4. And it looks like they will repeat as you get higher. So you'll get the same one again, but they'll add the fire to it, they'll add the prism effect to it, they'll add the gold effect. So that's how you unlock the different variants of the regen banners. In regards to anything fancy, I'm hoping there's some hidden camos, something that's kind of like dark matter maybe, that if you max level something or an entire class, you can get something special. I don't see any of that in the game going through patches, banners, camos. I also want to clarify something really quick when it comes to camos and regen. Some people are a little confused. I made a comment in my first video about something that resets when you regen. So I just hit regen 4, and here I've got these camos of my pilot, these top 5 right here. They reset, because I'm not level 10. So the level 10 Frontier Woodland, the level 20 Triforest, level 30 Frontier Sea, level 40 Blood Zebra, and the level 50 Warship Collage, all reset. Everything else you've ever unlocked for your guns, for your Titans, nothing resets. So all of these are still here. All of these are still here. This was, that was for execute 10 pilots. So this was probably for 5 pilots. This was probably for 3 pilots. Those are all still there. None of that resets. So all of your progress for everything you've done stays. Just those original 5 right here for level 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50 reset. Let's see, what else? I don't know if there's anything else to go over. I pretty much, for the kit ones, fast regen has been my go-to. I don't like phase and bark. To climb in your Titan, let's say it takes 2 seconds, phase and bark makes it 1 second. So it's not, there's not any situation where I'm like, God, I really wish I had phase and bark turned on. The fast regen helps me more. It's, you get your health back super fast in this game, especially with fast regen. Pop around a corner, slide around a corner, pop a hologram, get out of there, throw this on, good to go. The power cell, I don't really use it. Same thing with the ordnance expert, don't really utilize it. Here, I know I had some people tell me the other day, hover is top tier, god tier, pros use hover. I'm seeing hover used more and more, and I don't know if they're using it because some YouTuber or some streamer is using it. Again, I don't really watch other people's stuff. From what I've seen people use hover. They just die that much faster. It doesn't trick me. I don't like look up as they jump and then try to lead my shot downward as they fall. So it doesn't trick me. They don't get the advantage. It just basically allows me to zone in and get a headshot that much quicker. I did see somebody, there was one guy that was a Gen 3 with me early on when I was in early Gen 3 in a match. He was using hover, and he was kind of smart about it. He would jump up and hover, like, so he would head glitch a wall. He would jump up and hover at a wall just high enough to shoot. And he wasn't by any means dominating. He was just kind of a nuisance. Like, he wouldn't really get a kill. He wouldn't be hovering long enough to be accurate. But he'd pop up, and you'd get hit, and you'd look, and he'd be gone. He'd pop up, and you'd look, and it was just annoying. So there's some bonuses to it, I guess. Not for me. I think kill report is probably the most powerful, because then you can at least... Like, for instance, if you're chasing somebody, and you're not looking at the kill feed, and you're panicked, you're running, you got stimpacked, they got stimpacked, and you go around a corner, and you see the orange skull and crossbones on the field, you know he's dead. So you don't have to sit around and be paranoid that he's somewhere nearby. So the kill report's probably the best. Wall hang I do like for objective modes if you want to be the douchebag hanging on a wall. I took it. I typically always use wall hang. I took it off because there was a couple situations where I was jumping off of something and ADSing to kill somebody, and it stuck me out of the wall and threw me into hip fire, and I lost the gunfight. So I took wall hang off, and I went back to kill reports. Low profile is kind of neat. I wish it made you silent. I thought it did at first, but it doesn't say that it does. I gotta do some testing on it. It just says that you don't have any jet trails and you're silent when rodeoing. If it made you silent, like your footsteps weren't hearable by other players, I would use this quite a bit. I poop on a lot of guys when I hear them. There's a lot of times I'll be running around with something and I hear footsteps or a boost ability, and I'll slide in 180, shoot a hologram, and sure enough, somebody comes out of a door or over a cliff, and I drop them because I'm already waiting for them. So if that gave you dead silence from like Call of Duty, that would be my favorite ability. Yeah, so those are those. The assassinations. I prefer not to assassinate. I did go ahead and unlock the execute your foe with their own pistol. I have yet to pull it off. I try not to assassinate because of the animation. It gets me killed, which makes me angry. So that's that. I need to... where is it? Oh, and factions. Factions aren't really anything fancy. My aces are what I pretty much use. They're the alcoholics. I've got them up to 8.4. The leveling your factions up also give you banners. And then they also give you, every time they level up, they give you advocate gifts. Where I clearly have too many. I've got 35. That's only because I want to make a video of opening all 35. They might also offer double XPs. Clearly, I haven't opened my last 35, so that could be how you get double XPs. That is how you get Coliseum tickets, if you guys are curious. It's out of the Advocate gifts. You can randomly get an Advocate gift in a match, and you also get an Advocate gift every time your faction levels up. Call sign patches, banners, boosts. And then something just to throw out there to have it on video. They've been constantly tweaking the menus. Some of people, I don't think, know that there's a second menu. If you scroll over, you've got three more game modes over here. You can actually do private matches, which is kind of cool if you want to test stuff out. I'm going to be in there testing abilities and shit out with my buds. But they moved Free For All over to here, and they moved Capture the Flag over here, and then they brought into the first page the 8v8 mixtape and mixtape. These used to be called Variety, so Variety and 8v8 Variety. I don't know why they changed the name, but they're constantly working and adding things and changing things, which is cool because that leads me to believe that they are going to be adding all kinds of content like they did in the first game over time. Something else they've been constantly working on. I guess there was an issue with network invites and keeping the party together. They fixed that. They added and fixed the party thing early on. So Respawn is heavily active in this game. And it might feel like they might have some stuff missing now. But who's to say that they're not going to be adding stuff? I'm hoping that they'll add a leaderboard system and a stat page. Something. The data's all there. So it's not like it's not. So if they were to implement it a month from now, I would assume it would carry all your stats over. The data's in the game. It's in the servers. It doesn't get erased, so I don't know why they don't have a leaderboard for it. I get told I say too much. Anyway, I think that's all I'm going to go over. This has been entirely way too long of a video. So if you stuck with it, awesome. If not, I'll try to make them shorter next time. It wasn't really planned out. But yeah, that's basically everything I've noticed from the last week. 4 days worth of play. Gen 4. The purple that I'm rocking in the background on my character is the Gen 4 camos. I typically will be wearing that every time I do a video. But until next time, I will catch you guys later.